This is the spin for towels and sheets. On this GE, the spin bot doesn't bother me. I get quite a bit of vibration, but I really don't think it's unreasonably loud. This thing isn't jumping all around. My biggest disappointment in this machine is the water fill, and I can't seem to get the deep fill to deep fill. It fills up about 5 to 6 inches max at the bottom, and that's it. And that's what I don't like about it. But as far as the spin goes, when the spin is balanced, it seems to be okay. I mean, I don't really mind this. Show you what it looks like if I go into the next room or sound like. Here's the noise of the spin. And I'm in a hallway right outside the laundry room. I'm walking down the hall and entering my kitchen. I can hear it from the hallway right here. And in the kitchen, barely. As I get closer, there's my unfinished Monet house painting, Claude Monet, and I'm in that laundry room right now. Laundry room, scrapbook room. Oh, and we have moved. The tide has vibrated to the edge. That's interesting. So a slight vibration. Actually, the man is coming within an hour to replace this machine because it doesn't fill up enough. But I wanted to show you the spin vibration of this GE. A lot of people want to know what it sounds like when it's spinning. I mean, it's not all clunky. I think it's average. Average from what I've experienced. But like I said, that's not what's bothering me about this machine. It's the fill, the amount of water that fills. Even set on deep fill, that's why I purchased this. I wanted a deep fill setting. full review if you want to look at my full review on this machine. Anyway, that's the spin action of this GE machine. This is the 4.6.